If only we had obvious rules written into Microsoft Project to help someone who's just starting out with Microsoft Project use the software correctly. That's my dream, and one day that dream may come true. But until it does, here are the steps for working with Microsoft Project I wanted you to know. 1. Put in a project start date. 2. Select your project calendar, either from an existing list of calendars that are in the Change Working Time window, or design a brand new calendar, because one that's specific to your company, your organization, your project's needs does not exist. Create your tasks. Create your resources. Assign those resources to tasks. And then at that point, you need to save your baseline. I'll show you that in a moment. And then from there, you can begin tracking your project. If you're not following this list, you're going to run into lots of unusual things in Microsoft Project that you really can't understand and would be difficult to explain. But following this logic makes things more apparent to you when you're working with Project. You see, first you set up your project start date, then you choose a calendar, and then you begin making your project. Let me show you. I'm on a blank project screen, and the first thing I'm doing is not typing in a list of tasks. The first thing I'm doing is going to the project menu and choosing project information. When I do that, I can select the start date for the project. You know, some people actually work backwards, and they don't schedule things from the project start date. They actually schedule things backwards, meaning that they select schedule from the finish date. And that's why they can put in a finish date. We must finish by the end of 2010. And so they might be compelled to put in December 31st. Once you've chosen project finish date, you cannot input the project start date. But some people like to think backwards. The difficulty with this decision is that when you do that, every task will not start as soon as possible. Every task will start as late as possible. In effect, it will push all of my tasks to the end of the year. Now, that's fine if that's appropriate, but since we haven't really done that yet in any of the lessons, I'm going to switch back to the conventional project start date, and we'll choose to start this project on Monday, the 25th of the month. Over on the right side is where I choose my calendar, and again, this is where you'd select a calendar, or if one doesn't exist that matches your needs, you'd go into Change Working Time and either edit the standard calendar or build your own, something you'll be learning about later. I'm going to choose standard and click OK. I put in my tasks, whatever they may be, that indicate the work that needs to be done to complete your project. I'm just using some generic ones, task 1, 2, and 3. Maybe there are relationships between these tasks. And again, as you will learn later in the planning process group of our course, you can highlight them and click a linking button on the toolbar to link them together. This indicates that the first task must finish before the second task can start. And you can see that indicated with those arrows that are on the Gantt chart. Next, you go into making resources. So I choose View, and I choose Resource Sheet. And this is where I can type the names of resources, like Aaron, and maybe Betty, and maybe Charles. All of those are resources that I can now use in my project. I'll go back to the project screen by going back to the Gantt chart view. And as I said, you can change the split bar here, and you can see where there's a column for resource names, and you begin to choose the resources. Now, some people will not have specific names for their resources. They'll have specific job titles: project manager, project coordinator, accountant, marketing department, those are all fine examples of resources, but you assign those resources to your projects so you can see their names here. Now, once you've assigned the resources, then you want to save your baseline. What is this baseline business? If I change to look at a different table on this Gantt chart, instead of looking at the one that's titled Entry, I'll choose the one that's named Variance. The Variance table will show a project manager the difference between what he or she had originally planned and the actual start and finish dates once the work begins. The Variance table shows you start and finish, baseline start, baseline finish, and will calculate a start variance and a finish variance, indicating whether or not things started earlier or later than expected, things finished earlier or later than expected. But there's no way you will ever get any statistics on your three tasks unless you save a baseline. And since you may have reached that point in your planning where the project is starting to come into focus, you need to save the baseline. And that's by going underneath the Tools menu and choose Tracking and choose the menu choice that says Set a Baseline. I'll click that and the window will pop up that enables me to set the baseline. When I do that, I want you to notice how the columns Baseline Start and Baseline Finish will be populated by the current start and finish dates that you see in the columns on the left. Once I've done that, now I have effectively preserved the original plan. And when time comes to begin tracking the project and put in actual starts and actual finishes, then the variance table will calculate any differences. Where would I go to track a project? I'd go to a different collection of columns, not the variance table columns, but the tracking columns, because the tracking columns have columns named actual start and actual finish, or percent completion. That's where I can begin to track the status of a project that is in progress. All of these are task-related information. You remember when we began, all we were looking at was the entry table to show you columns of information related to entering of the tasks. But this is not where you'd be tracking the project. It's on the tracking columns, and certainly not where you'd see variances. You'd see those looking at the variance columns, provided you set the baseline. The seven steps. Put in a start date. Select or design a calendar. Create your tasks. Build your resources. Assign them to those tasks. Set the baseline. And then begin tracking your project. In a nutshell, those are the rules for Microsoft Project. Thanks for watching.